It's a great day. First of all, happy Veterans Day.
Happy Veterans Day.
Thank you for all your service, all the men and women out there. We appreciate it. Ironic enough, A Tribe Called Quest, their new album dropped today.
Woo! And they're veterans.
Was that the game.
Is that the segue?
Yeah, that was the segue. Because we got it from here. Thank you for your service, is what I'm trying to say.
Oh, there you are. Sorry, I jumped ahead of you.
He has it from here.
Anybody who's watching, I'm a huge Tribe. We are all huge Tribe fans. This is a big day. We didn't know if we would ever get to this day, and Ali Shaheed Muhammad kind of dropped a hint when he was here on the crew show a couple months back, but we are glad that it's here. It's finally here. Yeah. We got a chance to preview the album, and man, honestly, I'm very impressed. I'm pleasantly surprised and happy. My first impression was basically, this sounds like vintage Tribe. You know, and I shouldn't say vintage. I should say it sounds like Tribe at their best, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, I had expectations thinking like, how is Tribe Called Quest, like, who came out of this huge sample era and really created the pace for, you know, the biggest of artists like Kanye West or whoever that kind of like looked up to them. How do they take that traditional, historic, legendary sound that they created on all these albums and update that to where, you know, like, what does it sound like now? What's the new take on that?
Right.
And I think for me, the integrity of it stays in line with everything they've ever done, with just, like, it just sounds current. And they're obviously, they're talking about current topical matters and such
exactly.
as well. So, but I think they did a phenomenal job at capturing their, you know, adding another piece to their legacy.
Their essence.
Yeah.
Well, I think the excitement of when Q-Tip, you know, put out the letter, and then when they released who was a feature, who's going to be featured on the album. Like, just even to see, you know, names such as Anderson .Paak, and it was great to see Kanye and of course Busta and Khan. I was like, wow, they're just excitement alone. I was like, I'm ready to hear this.
And then when
I did get a chance to listen to the album, I was really impressed.
Yeah,
because I didn't know what to expect.
I'll be honest, I couldn't even get past the first two songs. Like, I had to repeat hearing like the first part when Q-Tip comes in, talk about, and you know, I don't want to get all political or anything, but they do have their track list is pretty relevant to today's know world that we're living. But the first line Q-Tip says, I believe it's like something from left to right, you know, and already he's making a statement about the political time to go left and not right. I thought, I was like, okay, we're in for a treat right here, because we're getting Tribe talking about current, you know, like you said, current events and what the world, what we're going
and
through.
And Tip
right,
like, Tip is like, he's just, he is culture to me, like, not just music, but like fashion to style, the way the album is produced too, like, not to get ahead of ourselves here, but it almost sounds like, I'm processing how they made that one, it almost sounds like they ran it through like Ableton, where like they actually, it's like a living, breathing kind of project where the tracks kind of like echo and there's a lot of reverb and it changes and there's filters and such. It's almost like they finished the album and then like went in and wrote it through like almost a DJ would, and kind of like added all this extra energy and movement to it and such.
It does sound almost like a mix.
And
like
Tip's a dope DJ. Like, obviously his selection, his sample selection is always like the craziest. So to hear what he did with this was, you know, really dope.
I was telling Vinny, like, the one concern that I had was, I was wondering if they were going to do old Fife verses. You know, because I'm like, dang, like, how are they going to pull this off, you know? But then as you listen to it, you go, okay, this clearly was his verse for this track.
That's another part of this too, is like, the beautiful thing about Tribe was, and I guess more of that era of rap period, but like Tribe, like, you know, was so amazing at it, was the way they bounced back from each other in verses within a verse, like that element of hip-hop doesn't happen too often these days, where you can tell they're in the studio together or they had a concept, even if it was individually, where it was like, all right, you're gonna do this, I'm gonna do this, and like, it's, there's a connection between it. Most collabos, if you will, or groups now happen like, you got the first verse, I got the second verse,
and in many
cases, they're not even in the same studio where they just send it across and they send the files back and forth, and you know, greatness can happen from that as well, but you can feel the vibe and the way when Busta finally comes in.
I was about to say,
like when he makes his first appearance on the album, like just the way he comes in, it just feels like he, I feel like, I almost feel like he sat through the whole making of all the other records and was just kind of waiting his turn. And then like, that was when like, okay, this is where I'm going to jump in now. Like, you know,
exactly.
And that's how it feels. It really is like a living, breathing, piece of music.
Yeah,
you know?
No, and Solid Wall of Sound is that when Fife and Buss are going back and forth, it's like, man, it sounds so good. Mm-hmm. It sounds so like it sounds today too, which is amazing.
But sounds great. Like vintage them.
Exactly.
Though. That's like,
I will say this. I was talking to E-Man before I came in about just like, I've been deep diving in hip hop like for like the last few weeks. Like, I've been trying to find every new cool artists, like things with buzz from all parts of the world.
Yeah.
And one thing that's happening now is just the overuse of just 808s and just like, and I love a good 808, like
we all do. Sure.
But hearing like drums that aren't just typical 808 drums, like hearing breakbeats again, hearing that, that alone gives it this different feel and adds that kind of live, you know, soulful feel that I think is missing in most of hip hop. And I think that comes from a few things, right? Like a lot of producers and artists don't like to sample because you give up publishing on it and things. But you know, when you're at this caliber and when you have this type of influence, I mean, I actually just made a sample playlist recently of all these albums. And it took me forever because what they would do is, you know, there would be four
layers.
There'd be like four samples.
Four on
one record. Exactly. It'd be the drums, something that was interpreted for the hook, and then there was the actual disco sample, and then there was a funk intro. There might have been a comedic, like Richard Pryor, like vocal, like or like whatever it is. Like there's so many pieces of
like Check the Rhyme, Minnie Riperton, Average White Band. Yeah, I mean, and it delves deeper and deeper. Scenario. Yeah.
So that was the other part of this. Was like, how do you That was the era where you could do that, right? Like that's the reason why like there's not like you can't get De La Soul albums like digitally is because they can't clear Grease samples.
By the way, we don't want to forget you, De La, either. This album just dropped. Yeah. It's fire.
Also good.
It's fire. So anyway.
But you know what I'm saying? So like I was concerned with like how do they keep that live feel, but you can tell there's definitely a lot of live instrumentation. But I think I mean, listen to this, like, just
the way this shit drops, like, you're talking about the drums and whatnot.
Yeah. This sound like, this is Dilla.
This is Dilla. Yeah. Dilla, for sure.
We don't believe you, cause we the people are still here in the rear, yo, we don't need you. You ain't killing off good young nigga move. When we get hungry, we eat the same fucking food.
Yeah.
The ramen noodle. The simple noodle.
That's pretty good. it's crazy.
That's a prime example.
And like,
saying,
the use of his vocal like that.
Yeah.
That you know, echo chamber type of vocal on his vocal. Such it adds like
another layer. It reminded me of his rap on, is it Get It Together?
With the Beastie Boys.
That's what that sound reminded me of.
Yep. That's
for
funny.
Sure. For sure.
And it also sounds a little bit like his mix show, like Astrap Radio.
Right.
So like he's using a lot of the sounds.
Yeah,
a lot of
that's what I'm saying. It sounds like almost a DJ set in the way they move and like the outro is like where they're the beats and there's a lot of like, it almost sounds like he ran it through Ableton, like not to get super techie, but I'm like trying to imagine like how he did it,
like the
effects. It doesn't sound like a lot of producers will go in and look at a screen and chop and look at numbers. This was approached from a strictly audio feel way, like it's a vibe. It's like a, you know, chop and duplicate type of thing. This is like write it, do it again and get it right, you know.
Yeah.
So.
You know, me and Vinny had a conversation yesterday too when we got a chance to hear the album. This is where we really started hearing Jerobi as part of the, you know, as you know, rapping and
right. He's on the first verse of the. I've never really heard Jerobi rap.
No, because you know, in the earlier tribe days, he was just considered a.
He's like a contributor, like the heart and soul, energy of tribe.
Cons was more prominent, but Cons was always kind of like an unofficial member.
Yeah.
Right.
And that
transition in 96 with the Beats, Rhymes, and Life album, and people were like, who's this guy now and whatnot. But at the end of the day, he's definitely a tribe family. But so favorite tracks?
I like Ego. Ego's a pretty dope track.
Man, that Ego to me, well, the first few joints are great, and I still, forgive me, I don't really know the track names
That's the thing that sucks with digital, like, because...
Right, I don't have the album
You consume it in
right
your
now.
Car, and your phone, here, you know, like, and so, like, it's almost, I have to refer to, so I'm cheating a little bit right now.
Yeah,
I'm gonna have to go with, Tokyo Conrad, or Conrad Tokyo, that's
what
I'm
like.
But yeah,
this is the track that E and I love, because it sounds like, that vintage Tribe. That bass line,
It's a vibe, There's no easy payoff.
Ego, ego, skip the chipping in my mind. Ego, ego, skip the chipping in my mind. Ego, ego, chipping, ego. I got one, you got one, and now we equal. Sometimes it makes you trip out on your people. Sometimes it has connotations of evil. Sometimes niggas go on it when they need to. It's called the ego. It's hard to really make the subject positively stated. Some may hate it, and some may overrate it.
That's Vince's track. Yeah. Okay. You know what I mean?
Like, I think this is finest. One of two tracks that Jack White is featuring.
Yeah, that's crazy. Jack White.
Yeah. Do you think, like, I'm gonna be like the fucking, like, I'm not trying to be like negative towards this. Do you think this connects with like teenagers?
Good question.
Now,
good question.
Like, do you think like Kendrick and people and Cole, do you think they've reopened like younger audience? Because I look around, we're all over 30. I'm assuming you're over 30.
I'm over 30.
I'm over 30.
Yeah. Like, you're 32.
I'm 27.
That's DJ 32.
Yeah.
Like, do people like appreciate this?
You know what?
Like, I mean, they're doing SNL this weekend.
Guess what?
With Chappelle. Yeah. Like, that's huge.
Yeah.
Are people gonna tune in for it? Like when you compare that against like, you know, a pop act or something, like how does this compete in like music period right now?
I hate, this is gonna sound like a Donald Trump answer. Who cares?
Yeah.
I really don't care. If you young kids, I'm sorry, I'm on the generalizing, because they got a joint on here called This Generation as well. That's dope as hell.
By the way,
but
what's the sample from for the hook?
What's that? You
Musical Youth.
Musical Youth. Okay,
thank you.
Anywho, I'm not trying to diminish you guys' feelings. I know there's a lot of sensitive I don't millennials out there, but
let the comments
listen,
fly.
Listen. This is a great album, and if you get a chance to like listen to it and also just go back.
Yeah.
Like you'll be surprised, because a lot of your favorite artists,
yes,
this is their,
yeah, and that's I guess that's what them, that's what I wanted to get know? To was for the parents that are watching
right.
this, like, for
right.
people that have kids that maybe all they listen to are like the current climate of music and hip hop and pop music and such. For me growing up, Tribe was actually one of the groups that introduced me to jazz.
Hell yeah.
Right? Like,
absolutely.
Like, it opened the door to another level of music that I wasn't really brought up around, right?
For sure, yeah.
And I think when albums like this drop, and it is hip hop, this is an opportunity for people that have interest in their kids having a broader selection of music and such. When Jack White's on the album, when it has so much jazz influence and such, this is an opportunity to teach your kids or to show how wide hip hop can be and how range that is not just, you know, funneled through this like narrow pipeline.
That's a better answer.
Look who's on the album. You have Anderson .Paak, you have Kendrick Lamar, you have Busta Rhymes, Andre 3000, you have Talib Kweli.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you have...
You're right, though, Reflex, because, you know, yeah, growing up in the quote-unquote golden era of hip-hop, we were exposed to a lot of great, between Pete Rock samples and everything. We just like, yo, where's that influence coming from? What's that sound, you know? And so it opened up our eyes and ears to, like, different
And again, music. And again, it's not even just... It's that people don't... popular music does not sample... too much anymore.
Right. Like
there's the reinterpretations, and it might be, oh, that sounds
interpolations,
But just that element of classic music being reinvented and such, it's not something that happens too often. I mean, like Bruno Mars will take, like, you know, a Zapp and Roger feel and just recreate it into his own thing, so don't get me wrong, that sound.
Morris Day type.
Yeah, and it's cool, like, that's cool, but, like, the actual way this is put together is a very different thing for me, you know?
But to your point and to your question, I think those new artists, if you're a fan of Anderson .Paak, if you're a fan of even Kanye and a fan of Kendrick, let this be the introduction of who A Tribe Called Quest is.
Do
your homework and see what they did for hip hop back in the day.
And you know, and being completely transparent, growing up, I guess at my age point and where I grew up in outside of LA in Southern California, I wasn't overly exposed to this.
Sure.
Yeah. It wasn't until I really joined the party. Like, I knew, like, Electric Relaxation, and I knew, like, the award tours.
Yeah, right.
But I didn't, like, let those records soak in. I was, like, exposed. My cousins and what I was raised around was Ice Cube,
NWA,
DJ Quick, like, NWA, like, all West Coast rap stuff. Like, that's what I was, you know, surrounded
exposed
by.
To.
Yeah, there wasn't much jazz influence type of stuff. Even though, I mean, you could argue that some like Warren G and Dr. Dre and Quick too had jazz
for sure. Right.
And but that was like for me like that same thing. Like when DJ Quick would always have like a interlude that had like a jazz like Quick's Groove.
Right.
You got the
right.
Like that was like a way for me to be like, this is weird. Like what is this? And like this, but I like it. How do I get this? And like he did it. You know, the Roots did it. And I think this signifies again how much hip hop. Like, if you don't already know, especially for a millennial, that this came from something. Hip-hop didn't come out of thin air. Hip-hop wasn't created yesterday. Hip-hop goes back many, many years and has went through many transformations to get to where it is now.
Yeah.
And I think this album reminds us of where it started and where it is now. You know,
this is actually where I bought. This was the tape. This is my first introduction to Tribe Called Quest. I lost the tape, though.
So for the young listeners,
this is where
young
I mean,
people watching, this is a cassette tape.
This is a cassette tape, right? They're redoing it. It's kind of cool now to have these again.
Yeah.
But this was my first intro to Tribe, and not like you said, I kind of knew about Bonita Applebum just watching videos and different things like that. But this album right here is what made me a fan, you know. And then I kind of went backwards, like. Yeah. Revisiting people's instinct to travel, but then here's Midnight Marauders. Excuse my language.
Yeah, here's the other thing about Tribe, and I think there's only been a handful, maybe a few more artists in hip hop that have made albums that, go through the test of time, I guess.
Yeah.
And almost sometimes age better.
Yes.
Yep.
And this is an album this album just came out today, really officially last night or at midnight. This is our first take on it. I'd love to like sit back down with you guys again in like 5 years from now and like be like, are you still listening? Like, you know what I mean? Because we go through music so fast now. Like music and albums get processed and every single day.
Yeah.
And the way that people consume them are so, I mean, I was having this conversation about Frank Ocean's album.
Right.
You know, how people were crying over it for weeks. Like, where is it? We got to get this Frank.
Mm-hmm.
And to be honest, like, I don't hear people talking about like the Frank. I mean, not to discredit
how
amazing
it is.
It's really good. But people have like this, like, yeah, I want that. I want it. And then it comes, and then they're like, all right, what's next?
Yeah.
You know, this is the type of album I think that people are going to live with for a while, and favorites will change.
Yeah.
Yep.
And you know, I think that's a testament to this piece of work that they did. Yeah. You know.
I like how this reminds me of how To Pimp a Butterfly is.
Yeah.
Only in the sense of for the younger people who are like, you know, how is the sound? Just imagine To Pimp a Butterfly, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Using that jazz with that hip hop as well. And this is definitely a spawn of like the Tribe Called Quest, you know, movement, you know what I mean?
Thank you, RIP Fife Dog.
Yeah.
We love you, we miss you, and man, thank you Tribe for dropping this album. It is definitely needed in this climate that we're living in today. Look at the track list alone, you'll get excited because it's Tribe talking about current events, and we appreciate once again, happy Veterans Day, and thank you again, Tribe. We got it from here. Thank you for your service.
I just want to add, if you care about this music, if you love this type of music, then spread the word.
Yeah.
Use your platform to spread this message, and I'm doing that, and I hope you guys share this with your friends and family, that people that appreciate it. And for all you adults on Facebook and parents that have kids that don't know how to appreciate this style of hip-hop music, expose it to them.
Yep. Force feed it
like strap them down and feed it to them like broccoli or something.
That's legal now. So
not
Donald Trump's
going to be president.
Like that's illegal. Yeah. Yeah. You do that.
Yeah. Now that Trump's president, you can totally lock your kid in a room.
Oh my God.
It's fine. It's fine.
It'll all work out.
And when you get a chance, like, you know, maybe
yeah,
take
back
a look,
track. Go backwards,
take
too.
A look at the Midnight Marauder album from the back and see who all these people are and how much they've contributed to hip-hop.
You are know? You on there?
Yeah, there's
you should right.
I'm on the repress.
I think that was right there.
Thank you, y'all. Appreciate you guys joining the discussion.
Happy Veterans Day.